Hello everyone, it's Rad. Welcome to Rad Gotaro channel, and this video is going to contain a general tarot reading. And for that reason, as general tarot reading, the reading itself is going to relate to different subjects and situations and is going to manifest itself in a different way with every single different person. Now, in case you are interested to know about specifically about your personal situation, you can check out my website, which is listed here in the display, or it is as well shown in the description of the video. And there you are going to find, visiting it, you are going to find on the very front page full list of my services as well as their pricing, starting from just as little as $12 for the recorded readings and $15 for the private call readings. Apart from that, if you want to see me live, or you know, you want to contribute with an event on me, you can check out my Facebook page, which as well you can see here on the video or in the description down below, and consider sharing and subscribing the video, because this is a one-man operation and your support does helps a lot. That being said, I want you now to lay back comfortably and enjoy the show. All right, so this is going to be a Cancer Sun, Cancer Moon, and Cancer Rising. Weekly tarot reading, July 8th to July 14th, 2019. And bear with me a second, guys, to shuffle the cards. And we are to jump straight away to the spread. Oops. It's still stiff. All right. Okay, so the first card, which represents the topic for Cancer's week, this is going to be the Magician card, followed by the second one, which stands for the challenges that you will have to overcome throughout the week, Cancer. This is going to be the King of Wands. The third card is standing for the positive aspect of the week here, and that is going to be the Judgment, the Justice card, excuse me. And the last one that we do have is going to be the guidance that tarot is offering to you, and this will be the Ace of Swords. So once again, the Magician is the first one, which stands for the topic, followed by the second one, which is the challenges, King of Wands here. Afterwards, we do have the positive aspect, that is going to be the Justice, and then the final one that we do have, that will be the guidance, and that will be the Ace of Swords. So we have a very narrow kind of reading, and how can I describe it? Well, this reading, you know, have many faces, you know, and one of the faces is very narrowed, and it does point that should you go through a legal matter this week, justice will be served, okay? And for that matter, you should be rather honest. And how can I describe it? Not withholding any information. And that will grant you that the justice will be served. Now, that doesn't mean, you know, that is going to be favorable for you, because justice, you may be on the other side of the justice, all right? So justice will be served, and that the outcome is going to be in your favor are two different things. But let's go in a more general aspect here, which is the topic of the week, and that will be the Magician. As a matter of fact, aside from this legal issue that this reading points, the reading does point to a fearsome competition, something like the Game of Thrones, you know, so something like the battle in between two kings, you and the King of Wands. So what happens here is that throughout the week, you are going to exert your personal sovereignty, and as well, how can I describe it, your iron will, showing yourself rather capable, you know, to perform into something, I would say it that way. So just to give you an example here, it could be that, let's say, into your career, there is that project which your boss is baffled whom to give it to. There is a very good candidate for it, but this week you are proving to be just as good as this person, which is the King of Wands. And there we go, a competition forms. It could be, for example, that there is that girl into your social circle that someone is, how can I describe it? You know, someone is kind of like trying to hit on her and she almost budge out, while this week you're proving yourself even capable, you know, you're proving yourself capable to be just as good as this one, all right, if not better. So there is the competition as well. So you do have a differences with that guy, or with that girl for that matter, because the King of Wands may not be only a man, you know, it could be a woman. But let's focus for now upon you. So the magician here points that this week you are going to have a strong determination, all right? So whatever actions you do, they will be supported with that conviction that you mean what you do, and that will exert a strong belief and as well confidence in, you know, it's going to exert confidence, you know, in your actions. So people are going to believe in you, and you are to win as well a lot of followers here, a lot of supporters. On top of that, it seems, guys, that you are, will perform with ease whatever it is thrown at you, either as a tasks, you know, or as a competition material as well. So you will have no problem to jump into action here and just resolve the matters, whatever matters are thrown at you. And lastly, it looks like as well that you are going to have an exceptional communicational skills with which you can achieve a awesome contract. For example, you can establish very good beneficial negotiations for yourself, or for example, if you are on a second interview here, negotiating the terms of which you are going to work at, for example, you are to negotiate for yourself pretty damn good salary, right? So do not neglect, you know, your communicational skills, and to try to strike a better deal, whatever that deal is all about. The accompanied card here is going to be the 10 of Cups, the formation. It is a active neutrals that we do have. And so all that is provoked by the, not ignorance, but by the denial, you know, that you have to be satisfied with what you have, all right? Knowing that you are better than that, okay? So if, for example, we are following this girl into your social circle, that someone else is trying to hit on her, but you do have feelings for her as well, one day you wake up and you are asking yourself, well, why I am any worse than the person that is trying to hit on her, and she's almost, you know, ready for him, all right? So I can do that as well, okay? And you probably are gonna do it. So it's simply, all this is provoked by the necessity of oneself to simply achieve better and to be better as well, either career-wise or either relationship-wise. The way I see it is, just beforehand, you have been somewhat intimidated by the competition, in the sense of that you probably believe that you ain't good enough, you're not as good as this person here, which is the King of Wands. So the King of Wands, as a challenge, that is your competitor. And they are very cocky. That is on the minus side, okay? They kind of like believe that what they are after, it is theirs to take, and they have no, no challenger along the way. Well, this time around, they are dead wrong about it. Also, this person, it's a rather optimist, they lack a vision upon, you know, what can go wrong. They always have that positive attitude toward the situation. And they always, how can I describe it, overperform, in a sense of that they try to be as perfect as they can, okay? And often extend beyond their personal limits. But for their plus, I would say that they are very capable to transform ideas into very powerful actions. So whatever they say that they are going to do, they simply try to do it. And I'm saying try to do it because not every time it works out, but at least they show the determination, you know, that they are going to do it. The accompanied card here is going to be the Six of Swords, the formation. It is a active friends. And this person is not afraid to do whatever it takes here with the Six of Swords, even things that you haven't anticipated, even things that you don't know them of, that they are capable of doing. So expect the unexpected from that King of Swords, a King of Wands, excuse me, which appears into your reading. That could be, for example, the jealous coworker that you it didn't even cross your mind that they could do something nefarious or something slinky here, but they did it, all right, just so they can get the spot that you are trying to get instead, all right? Or if this is a law of triangle, you know, you didn't even cross your mind that this which is friend of yours, or at least common owner, is going to speak behind your back, but they did it. Okay, so you have to be prepared for everything, from any, for any kind of very sneaky action from that person for throughout the week, so they can take the slightest edge here and to basically knock you off that competition. But should you be honest toward the situation and accountable here, justice will be served. What I mean is that, for example, if this person talks shit about you, all right, it's completely untruthful things about you, the truth is going to come around afterwards, as long as you are honest and as long as you are accountable toward the situation as well. The justice also, like I said, point that the justice is going to be served should you have any kind of a legal matters at hand. But as well, the justice here points that you are not going to give too much material of this person to take advantage of, I mean the King of Wands. It is because it seems that you are going to structure your priorities quite well throughout the week, and not just throughout the week, but from now on in relation to this endeavor here that it is marked by the Magician card, you know, whatever the endeavor is that you are competing with the King of Wands. And they simply ain't going to have any crack that they can simply infiltrate into your deal and take advantage of. So pretty much you're gonna close yourself, and if you do have any weakness, you're not gonna leave any like I said, crack, so that person can use that crack and to exploit your weakness. The accompanied card here is going to be the Queen of Wands. The formation, it is a active friends once again, and so with the Queen of Wands, you very well will have that acute sense what you have to do, all right? You are, on top of that, you alone are gonna know the weaknesses of the King of the King of Wands, and on top of that, you will have pretty good idea what is substantial for the requirements of this cumulative endeavor here that you are competing at. Meaning that, for example, if this is the girl that you both are competing for, you pretty much will know or will have a sense what that girl likes and what that girl expects from her potential suitor. If you are chasing similar project as this person and it's just a competition or a promotion at work, you will pretty much know or have a sense what your boss is going to be impressed at and what your boss is going to value it more than anything else, you know. So with this particular insight, or rather like a cute sense of what is needed, is going to give you the edge in this specific competition, in addition, you know, to your closing in, not allowing anybody to exploit any kind of weakness of yours. And so the last card that we do have is going to be the guidance one. And this is the Ace of Swords. So the Ace of Swords tells us a couple of things, and especially for those who are very gentle and milder into nature, is that even though they may see that they do have a competition, they may try to deny that truth, you know, thinking of, well, because they're too kind and too good, you know, they're kind of like, yeah, it's a competitor, you know, but I don't believe that this person is going to do that to me, you know, steal my project, steal my place, or steal my potential new lover. Well, you better believe it. It is what the Ace of Swords points. You have to be with that mental agility, if I may say it that way, or a mental clarity to foresee the situation for what the situation truly is, placing an accurate diagnosis upon it, and simply see that person, King of Wands, for what that person truly is. Additionally to that, the Ace of Swords here points to the time for being, for being somewhat passive are over. Now you have to establish very strong moves towards your goal. You need to show that you do want that goal, all right? And that you are willing to go as far as it needs to go so you can finally, you know, have that breakthrough or have your goal fulfilled. The accompanied card here is going to be the Nine of Cups, and the formation here, it is a active neutrals, and with this formation you need to be prepared for some, I cannot say disappointment guys, but some rather unpleasant states of emotions where, you know, it's kind of like everybody has them when I don't know what kind of example to give you. It is just, you know, could you believe that I run dry, for examples. It's like, you know, you're trying to be with a specific person and suddenly you fall in despair out of nowhere, that maybe you are not meant to be, or maybe, you know, you will not be able to be at the end. This kind of a state is what I am talking about, that you may be infiltrated by negative emotions, or are like an emotions of despair out of nowhere, because, you know, the job isn't done yet. I mean, you haven't reached that specific success into this endeavor. But don't you worry, it's completely normal someone to doubt into their performance and into the success of that performance as well. But as long as you don't show that in public and you don't show it as a weakness so the King of Wands can exploit that weakness, you know, you should be fine for the most part, unless you don't do something stupid. Because as the Magician is a very powerful card, giving you an edge almost over everyone. It's also a card pointing that sometimes if you are not careful, you can become a victim of the circumstances, okay? So if you cannot support your actions with determination, do not do those actions that you are anticipating, all right? Just try to collect more convincing arguments instead that are to support those actions in the future. So that being said, Cancer, this was your weekly tarot reading, July 8th to July 14th, 2019. I hope you enjoyed it and you liked it, guys, and we're going to see each other around. Until then, bye.